the shell, and he cut the end out of it and let the buckshot out of it and packed it full of lard. And he went back and he prodded the old mule in the butt with the shotgun. He wouldn't move, so he ran back and he shot him with that lard-filled shell. And the good news is the mule got to move it, okay? The bad news is so did the tobacco and the tobacco plants, and they turned the sled over and it run all tore up by a half acre of tobacco. Couldn't get him, you know, to stop and couldn't catch up to him. And so, you know, after that, we just let the whole mule go into retirement to heal his sore butt. But, you know, a lot of Christians, to get them to be led by the Holy Spirit, you'd about have to shoot them in the butt with some hot lard to get them moving. I mean, that the church needs to get moving, and we need to be on fire for the Lord. We need to be happy about this, that we're not condemned, but we need to be led by the Spirit. And if we're going to be led by the Spirit, our minds need to be on spiritual things, okay? And your mind cannot get on spiritual things unless you allow yourself to be led by the Holy Spirit. And see, the problem with that is we don't want to release control. If it weren't for that little issue with human beings, we could be a lot more spiritual. But we don't want to release control of our lives and turn it over to Jesus. But see, the Bible says if you want to keep your mind on spiritual things, you're going to have to relinquish control of your life, and you're going to have to submit to Jesus and His will, and you're going to have to be led by the Holy Spirit. And some people might say, well, Charlie, that sounds like a good idea, but I don't know how to be led by the Holy Spirit. Well, I can help you with that. Let me give you a couple pointers on how to be led by the Holy Spirit. Well, I'll tell you, first of all, there is no substitution for this right here, this book. If you want to be led by the Spirit, if you want God to speak into your life, if you want God to communicate to you, your first line of defense is the Bible right here. That's how God is going to speak to you. That's how God is going to lead you, is through His Word. Now, I know a lot of us like to get excited and you know, there's nothing wrong with being charismatic or whatever. And we get all excited and say, Lord told me this, Lord told me that, He spoke to my heart. But I'm going to tell you, the Lord is never going to speak something to your heart that He doesn't speak first in His Word. Amen. This is the number one way to stay in communication with God. This is the number one way to defeat the flesh. We are at war right now. We are at war between the spiritual side of us and the flesh side of us. And the flesh, the last thing your flesh wants you to do is to get up in the morning and open up the Bible and read it. And then some people say, well, I can't read the Bible. Guess what? They make CDs. All you have to do is put the CD in there and push play, and it'll read the Bible to you. I mean, number one, read your Bible. If you want to be led by the Spirit, if you want to defeat the flesh, then read your Bible every day. Charlie, I can't read that much. Can you read one verse? Can you read one verse? One verse of Scripture will change your whole day. One verse. You see, that's what the devil wants you to do. He wants you to get up, and it's like going hunting and forgetting your shotgun shells. You get out there and you get ready to shoot a deer and you ain't got no ammo. If you wake up in the morning, you ain't read your Bible, and then here comes some big battle in your life or some big problem and you need to face it, but you didn't read your Bible, then you're out of ammo. It's a famous saying. Man said, well, you know, George Washington said, or somebody said, if I was going to chop down a tree that was going to take an hour, I'd spend 4 hours sharpening the axe. A lot of people say, well, Charlie, I ain't got time to read the Bible. I got a busy day. Hey, I ain't got time to read the Bible and all that stuff because I got to go. I got to get out of here. It's a opportunity. When you get the chance, you read your Bible.